Yo, what up? This is Matthew Burnett. This is Jordan Evans. Just want to shout out Toronto's blog. This is Walder. Appreciate the love. Appreciate the look. You know what's up?
So when was the first time you guys heard Pound Cake?
Probably a month and a half ago. We heard a part of it. We were sort of given the concept for it, you know, so we had something to work off of, I guess. Mm-hmm. So yeah, a month and a half ago. Pretty recent.
Yeah.
So what did you think about the verses on it?
That whole song to me was kind of monumental and a bit surreal, I guess, given the context and how it all came together. But honestly, I loved it. I think it's classic hip hop. I think, you know, they're both just rapping their asses off, which is essentially what hip hop is all about, you know. So it was really refreshing to hear that, you know, two guys just going in and just doing what they do, you know.
For sure. So did you guys the Paris Morton Music 2 part as well?
No, I think that was another producer named Detail who did that.
Oh, that was Detail.
Pretty sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
I was credited as a writer. Mm-hmm. Jordan and Wonder were credited as producers.
Boy Wonder,
Boy Wonder, sorry. So I think I was the only person credited as a writer.
There's a
from the trio, I believe.
There's the way it works is they consider composer or a lyrical songwriter as a writer. So okay. Everybody, so even Jay-Z, Drake, all those guys get credited as writers, So
how that one came together was, you know, like George said earlier, we were given the concept for the record. And Jordan started something first. You know, he flipped the sample, the Ellie Goulding sample, and you know, he started the beat off, and then he took it, well, we both took it over to Boy Wonders. And then that's where it all kind of came together, you know, we all kind of got creative, and I started thinking of, you know, different ways to kind of make it, you know, essentially what it turned out to be.
Yeah.
And that's basically how the record kind of came together, you know, Jordan started it off, and then we all put together, and we all kind of, you know, chipped in our different creative inputs, and got the record finished.
I wanted to go with this sample, just because it was like, you know, the concept was to do some classic hip hop, so it was like, okay, let's get a wicked sample to, you know, to match with the sound, I guess the idea of the song. So, you know, I cut up the sample a little bit, you know, arranged it, put some little bit of drums on it, and then we brought it over and just like had fun with it.
So did you know Jay was gonna be on it, or that you were making it for Drake's album when you made the beat?
Yeah.
So you knew that beforehand?
Yeah. Which was great because it gave us a heading, right? It gave us like an idea of what, you know, what kind of feel you wanted beforehand. So it was really good, yeah.
Do you think that was Drake's best album? You heard the album so far?
I mean, it's early, right? It only leaked, right? It's only, it comes out on a couple of days, but from what I heard, I really like it. I think it's definitely one of his best.
I agree 100%. And I like that he took music, you know, he did something different. You know, he didn't necessarily repeat stuff that he's done already, you know, but when you listen to the album and you listen to the production, you listen to the flows, you listen to everything about it, like, it's fresh, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's really, really fresh, which is really dope, especially nowadays with so much music that is somewhat similar, you know? It's a fresh-ass album, which is amazing.
We're just working. There's a bunch of new guys that, like, new talent that we're trying to work, you know, develop with, and then, you know.
Mostly local guys, or?
I mean, a lot of people from Toronto, like, you know, I don't know if you know Party Next Door. We've been working with him a lot. He's amazing. So we're going to keep working and just, you know.
The biggest thing, I guess, for both of us, you know, our main focus is developing, you know, like Jordan said, developing talent. Because there's so much talent in Toronto. There's so much talent that a lot of people don't know about, you know what I mean? So we found a couple people who, you know, we obviously believe in. And, you know, our main focus of ours right now, in addition to doing everything else, and, you know, shopping our records and, you know, trying to get, you know, more hit records, basically plays and stuff like that. Our main focus also right now is also developing talent and, you know, making artists essentially.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Do you have any guys that people might know in Toronto that you guys are working with besides Party Next Door? Or you're kind of just starting from scratch?
I mean, no, there are definitely some amazing guys, like some new guys that are from our area, like Sean Leon. He's a great rapper, so he's he started at the beginning of his whole music.
Yeah, you guys did the majority of the production on his project,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly. He's really good. There's some other guys that we're working on. It's a little premature to really be, you know.
Yeah.
You don't want to put the stuff out there too early, but Charmin for sure. Yeah.
Yeah. It's gonna be
good. There's a lot of talent, so it's just about, you know, just trying to get everyone's stuff going.